UUID and ULID are both 128-bit, 16-byte block of data, but the layout of the block makes all the difference. There are multiple versions and variants of UUIDs, and 6 bits are reserved to describe them. Version 4 is the most common, and is basically secure random data, which provides good distribution and makes the ID hard to guess compared to sequential IDs. ULID, on the other hand, starts with a 48-bit timestamp field, encoded in big-endian, making them lexicographically sortable and giving them a time-based locality. The remaining 80 bits are for uniqueness. ULID are not compatible with UIDs, so migration from one to another is slightly more difficult, but the UID version 7 has the same property of ULID, so you should consider them instead. From a storage perspective, there is a huge difference between the two types of IDs. Random-based IDs like the UUID version 4, NanoID, CUID, and others provide a good random data distribution. This means that if we generate multiple IDs and insert them into the database, they will be scattered around, rather than clustered around a specific region. This is great if your database is distributed, as you'll be able to leverage all the nodes by distributing data and computation across them. However, for a traditional single machine database, using a standard B-tree, the random distribution will lead to fragmentation and increase the disk IO, affecting query performance. On the other hand, time-based IDs like ULIDs, UUID version 7, Snowflake's ID, XID, and more have a great time-based data locality. This means that when we generate multiple IDs within the same time window, all the data will be closely clustered together. If we have a single database machine, from a disk I/O and cache point of view, this is great, because we have fewer blocks to scan and keep in memory. We may end up with more contention on the locks when inserting and updating, but it should be better than doing long index lookup and disk I/Os, and if you are used to auto-increment rows IDs, there's not much difference. However, if you're using a distributed database, the time-based locality is going to create hotspots, ending up using just one or few machines instead of all the machines available. There are various techniques to mitigate this problem, but this is a topic for another video. As always, the choice depends on your use case. Going back to the data block, the canonical way to encode UUIDs as a string is to use base16 and separate the various parts with dashes. The canonical way to encode ULID as a string is to use croc for base32, which makes the string more compact. Both base16 and base32 preserve the lexicographical order, so even using string format, ULID will still sort by time. Both do not require coordination to be generated, and can be generated offline, which is great when you have multiple machines creating records. Most of the up-to-date databases have the UUID type support, so you should use that, but you can always use the binary data type. In this way, you just need to store and compare 16 bytes per ID. The randomness of version 4 UUIDs is great for opaque, non-guessable IDs, while the timestamp embedded within the ULID also enables you to utilize the IDs as a temporary token where the clients can examine the timestamp to determine whether it's expired or not, or just to maintain a chronological order of events without having to carry around an extra field. As always, the choice depends on your use cases. Understanding the characteristics and behaviors of the different type of IDs should help you with your decision. If you have any questions or want to know more, leave a comment below.